All right, we're back at Indy, and well, this did not go well for us in the Gen 4. That was at the new Indy. We'll see how this old Indy works. I believe that's what ARC is running at the end of the season, as well as old Indy. Not that there's a whole lot different, but yeah, it might be a little more one lane, like you would expect out of Indy. Not sure though. Haven't ran this version since the refresh. We didn't qualify. Holy crap, I just noticed the wind. Okay, 17 mile an hour wind that is blowing directly into our face. Turn 4 might be really difficult. Okay, it's dropped down to 14, but it's definitely going to be a high. Wait, why are those flags going the other way? I don't know what way the wind's blowing now. It looked like the wind was blowing in our face when we... No, okay. Maybe I was just reading those flags wrong, but it is going to be tricky out of 2. Okay, well... That's going to be interesting. I don't know what it was in practice, but... It didn't feel like there was any issue. But 1 and 2 is going to be more difficult. 3 and 4 should be a little bit easier. Just because you're going to have a lot more air on the nose. But first, we got to make it to 3 and 4. Which, the way that Indy races have been going, who knows if that's going to be a thing that we can even do. Back of the field accelerating. We're just gonna hang back a bit. We got 60 laps. Fuel window's extremely small. Only, like 4 laps. And we've got someone spun already. Deciding to join the track, even though there's this nice little access road. Can't change the gear, so we're going to be up on the red line. Yeah, you know what? Turning into 3 might be a little tougher, too, just getting it to pull into that wind. We've survived a lap, as has most of the field. Some big liftoffs here. Yeah, I'm not really feeling the wind, but we're also not putting it on the limit right now. It might be pushing us towards the wall on exit of 2, so we'll need to be careful of that. Into the straight, car does pull to the right, so that'll make sure we don't drive ourselves into the wall. As we do there. So we got loose up ahead. We almost got loose. Fighting very hard up ahead. There's not a lot of grip down low. That's the big difference I can tell you from how it feels from the new track to this track. It does not feel like there's a whole lot of grip down low for this track. Watching ahead, I know they're making some passes up there. Some of that could be the wind, though. Before, it felt like there was a little bit of grip, but we also did slide the last lap, so...
54.885. Does not look like we got a lot of speed. This is open. We're just using free OSR set, but car in the wall now. Calm down, guys. You don't have to enter so that you go up to the high side. You can slow down before the corner. Alright, so watch out for the 22. He's been struggling just a little bit. Grabs the wall. Feel like we're pretty in control of the car, but we're also going much slower than everyone else, I think. So once we start to push it, not sure how it'll go, but the line that we just saw out of the 22 was pretty impressive there. Apparently this guy wants to go, so whatever. Go ahead. Get him past us. Anyone with a spec map like that, we don't need to be around. I hope that guy can make the next corner. Gonna just run up high in case he didn't. We're not gonna pass you, dude. I'm not trying to win this thing from 20 seconds. Go forward and pull away from me. So, 1 and 2. It's getting a lot of people so far. The exit is the biggest thing. Looks like a lot of people are doing that. We nearly do it there. Ahead of us here. 54.673. Should have a nice clean pass into 3. Assume the 22 is going to back off and let him go. He does. Now we can go try to pass the 22. Don't think we're going to get there for turn one, though. But he's had a bad push out of 2 every time, so we'll try to set up something for that. Just give ourselves a bit of space. He gets the bad push, we get the run. Outside. 13 out of terrible exit. We're just gonna lift off here, not get to his inside. and hopefully he gets going. We'll give him a lap to get going, but if he keeps making mistakes off the corner, then we're gonna have to pass him. Good off the corner now. Maybe it's just the draft, I don't know. He's gonna race us. He didn't really have anywhere to drop in though behind us, so we won't take that as him racing us. Can we be okay in clean air? Yep, we overdrove that a bit. We're gonna have a bad exit, but they're in the wall behind us. We just need to back it down a little bit more into two. 22 mile per hour wind now. It is a windy Indiana day. Looks like the 16's quicker than us. He's catching up with us.
55.505.
These two are definitely slower. I think it's just the 19 isn't sure how to pass the 25. They're both gonna miss the corner. And just losing time, getting a little too low there. It off into one. Missed it. Big push. We'll let him go if he looks to our inside. Let him go separate these guys so that we can make passes. And he blows the corner. Is there a high side? Might as well find that out now. I have no idea what's going on ahead of him.
56.132.
Oh yeah, there might be a high side now. Turn two, though, I don't think you want to go there. We're just getting our butt kicked, though. I mean, we're in 21st and can't see anyone ahead of us. And it's not like we lost a lot of ground early on from a wreck or anything. Everyone's just pulled away massively. We are just very slow. That was an aggressive move. How far behind the leaders are we? 20 seconds almost. I thought was gonna hook the guy.
Outside.
He's gonna lift off for us, it looks like. Had to keep it really low there. Sure if he was gonna almost hook us like he almost hooked the 16. Yeah, I'm just not feeling the top side like what we felt on the other track, but it could just be the wind is really messing things up. Get it down so that we can not be close to the wall off of two. We're just slow. Man, this is bad. I mean, these guys are, I don't know what you even call that line. Get by him without getting wrecked on the straightaway.
Clear inside.
Okay. He's just been darty left and right. He lets us go. So hard to get it to turn 3-2. That crosswind on exit. You get a tailwind on entry and a crosswind on exit. Then you have the opposite here. It's pushing you wide on entry. Then here you really don't feel anything. It pushes you a little bit to the inside, but you just kind of have a lot of grip in forward. Alright, so 17th has fallen back to us.
55.888.
We just need to find a little bit of rhythm and speed. .2 to the 16th place car. Last lap on the delta bar once I get onto the straightaway so I can find out if high side is good or not now that we're not getting held up. Because I can't feel it, but it might be there. Great run though, 20 laps in. Let's get up here and see. No. It's not there. low line's the way to go. Which is good. You can maybe get away with it in one, but it's not worth it. I don't know. We're 10 slower this time. We'll find out for sure in 3 and 4. Well, I didn't even make it to the bottom, so really not gonna know. Reeling in some of the cars ahead of us, we can go 13 more laps. That'll get us to 34. That will get lapped, so we don't want to do that. Plus, I haven't practiced a pit stop here, and the pit entry cones are right there. So you gotta get going slow well before the other track. So I think we'll just go long, even though that's not really the best strategy at a big track like this, but with as far back as we are, it's just what we gotta do. How far back are we now? 21.7. We've lost 3 seconds since I last looked. But we are making up some ground now. Maybe get a top 15.
56.425.
I wouldn't even know what to change, if I could change anything on the setup, because it's loose and tight, and I think you just gotta go with what you got, since the wind is making it 4 completely different corners. Probably go harder through 4, but you don't need to hit the wall. Car ahead of us is really struggling. Thank you.
4.45 clear.
Try not to miss the corner. Thankfully, Technically, this is an Indy car, so I don't completely blow the corner anytime I try to make a pass. 4.5 and 4.2 ahead. The next car's 16 is just better than us, so we're not going to be catching up with him. He's still doing that higher exit. I don't like how that feels. So we're going to stick with the low side. Pretty much in the pit window. Make sure auto fuel doesn't screw us over for a green-white checkered. Make sure it gives us everything. We just got massively loose, as did the 16. Might have some people coming out of the pits ahead of us. Make sure we're getting tired. We are. I think we just got a few people ahead of us that are slowing down, so if that all of a sudden gets bunched up really bad, then we'll pit. But we'll end up going a lap down, and I don't want to do that. Nope. Too shallow of an entry. Kills our exit. Pretty much just doing a left-hand only road course race here, it feels like. Get this thing to turn a little better. Much better. All right. Under 4 seconds to the cars ahead of us. Just need to start slowing down a little earlier for 3. Tires are definitely struggling to turn in against the wind as they get older. Anything on that lap.
You have about 5 laps of fuel left.
Those guys are pitting, so that's good news. Most people are pitting, it looks like. So we're going to see a lot of pitting. But do not want to go a lap down. So we're going to be one of the last people to pit because I don't know when the leaders are going to be pitting. They clearly haven't yet. So we haven't got that call. Now the people that pit early are going to make up a bunch on us. That's fine. And most of the leaders aren't going to go a lap down, but all the people we are racing will end up going a lap down to the leaders until they pit. Which isn't a big deal if it goes green, but if an unlucky yellow does come out, then your race is kind of messed up. Guys are pitting. We will just continue on our way. Tires are catching us behind. We're not going to pit this lap, but we will pit the next lap.
You got about 2 laps of fuel left.
So a yellow doesn't do us any good because everyone that pits that isn't a lap down just won't pit because they won't have any need to. Biggest thing I'm doing here is just making sure I don't go a lap down when I pit and then have to take a wave around or a lucky dog. Leaders are pitting. No one can go, well, some people might be able to go one more lap, but that's not our concern. We're pitting here. Hopefully this guy doesn't try to sneak under us. I'm trying to pit, dude. Okay.
Pit boxing. 10, 5, 3, 2, 1, right here.
And 62.58. Not too terrible.
That's it, go.
Bad exit. We're not too far behind. 16 is right there. We just need to remember that we got a lot of wind and no banking here. Pretty sure the 12 car was ahead of us. He's running the high side. I just don't feel the speed up there. It definitely does not feel like what it felt like in all the other cars. Where are we cycling out here? for right now. There was someone that stretched it one more lap that was on pit road. Now we just drive around for 30 more laps and see if we catch anyone else. Try not to wear the tires too much. But we'll be doing a lot better at the start of this run since we're not waiting for all the cars to sort out in front of us, so we should be a little bit quicker. And hopefully we can not lose as much ground to most people. Tap. How far behind the leaders are we now? 30 seconds. We actually could get lapped by the end of this one. Probably not, but it could happen. Gotta remember, most of the time that we lost on the first run was in that early stage, just being patient with people racing each other. We shouldn't have to do too much of that. So we just gotta hope that we don't have a bunch of fall off since we're pushing the tires harder to start out. No idea what this guy's doing. Is he gonna lift off? Okay. We've not really went forward. Now the people that pit way ahead of us, or way before us, that we were catching at the end of the last run, they are 5.7 seconds ahead of us. So we'll watch that gap and see how it's dropping. It's probably gonna take a bit before it starts dropping. 15th, still a possibility. Lap there, it felt like. Five seconds to that car, so they've had a mistake or are already falling off hard. Which is good news for us.
7.
They are dropping hard. Problem is, the 12 car is slightly slower than us, but not slow enough for an easy pass, so that could check us up a little bit. Good news though, I think everyone behind us is slower. And on older tires, or the same tires, so without a mistake, we can only move up. And hopefully no yellows. That's a big mistake. Tires have hit their limit on heat, so now we just need to not try to push through that. Slow the pace down a little bit. We're still gaining. Distance to the leader, 34 seconds. So they're still gaining on us, but not at a rate that would lap us. Two ahead, so we've kind of evened out with that car that was dropping. The other guy, I think, is just ahead of him, going slow as well, so we've got three potential spots ahead of us. 12 is starting to struggle, but making that pass is going to be difficult. Stomp on the gas like that and lose all momentum. Big loose. 12 felt that as well. Getting really held up now. He's losing ground to us. There's about to be a pack of three, and possibly us two joining them. Big wobble. Lose all momentum. Off early because I wasn't really paying attention to his entry into one. I don't know if he was slower than us or not, and if we give ourselves a little bit of space for the exit of two, we should be able to get a run and take it to three. So we don't have to check up in the middle of two. push up and hit him.
Stay low. There is a car on the high side. Still there. Hold your line. Outside.
He lifts off finally there, and we've got the pass complete for now. Is he going to try to pass us back immediately? He does, because he doesn't want us to gain any time on the people ahead. It's not like we caught you from multiple seconds back, but congrats on losing some more time. Though. Very strange that he hasn't made the pass yet on these guys. On one of them, probably. Or just get really slowed down. And they're all having issues. Please don't come all the way back up to the wall. Overdrove that. So this ugly volunteer car has been hitting the wall a few times. We've got to be watching out for that. 14th and 15th are the only spots we realistically have a chance of catching. They're right in front of us, so we don't need to push this other than to push it to get ahead of them before the 12 catches us. But with everyone not adjusting for the exit of 2, should be fairly simple.
Outside. Still there, hold your line.
He lifts off. Well, I thought he was lifting off.
Clear.
He could have made that corner a lot easier on himself by lifting off and turning. But gave us a little bit of a gap to the 12 that might be quicker than us later on. We just need to be nice and calm here. The guy ahead has been making a lot of mistakes as well. Just ease it around. Seconds to the two cars ahead of this guy. That's a long distance. So we don't need to go any faster than just to stay ahead of the 12 and to catch this guy. But we're already in 15th. Only got 9 laps left. 1.1 ahead. There, pulling away from the 12. 16 still got to get around the 12. I'm just really surprised the 16 didn't try to pass these two when he got to them. I thought he was much quicker than that, but... maybe he was just taking his time and then got caught up avoiding their mistakes. Big loose 20 mile an hour wind might have been a part of that. So well, and then it's just based on what the wind's doing through two. There we were able to go a little more throttle through it because we had less wind. There we just overdrive the corner and pitch it sideways. Got the wall, doesn't slow him down all that much. Gets the wall again. 21 mile an hour wind. We do not turn into the corner, but that's fine because we know we really are not good at setting up a pass off of four anyways, so keeping our distance a bit is better for setting it up off of two. I don't want your draft anyways. I want a gap so that I can get a run on you off of two. Yep. You both pressed it a little hard there. Guy's going to be more concerned about the mirror than the walls.
Car outside. Still there, hold your line. Still there, hold your line. Outside is clear. 56.794.
Take it easy. And there we go. All right, P14. No other positions available. Now we just kind of back it down. Try not to slide it. It out of the wall. We should still be able to pull away from this guy. back push. What's the wind at now? Yep, 21. It would not turn in, and I let off pretty early. One more time around for the leaders, and this one's not going to have a yellow. Should have the white flag. So we are good to go. Anyone that wrecks on this last lap, we might be able to pass. But considering no one's really wrecked, just a bunch of wall hits, don't think we're getting any freebies here. It's actually kind of a fun race, but probably a little boring to watch just because it was so spread out. It, like I said, bit of a road course race there, really. We just made our way up. Didn't screw up our pit stop. No cautions to bunch the field up, but it was actually a really fun race. We were probably supposed to get 15th. With the 16 having an issue there when he was behind the 23.
Chicken flag.
That ruined his race.
Okay, we'll get him next
but
time.
It seemed like he wasn't able to pass once he caught him, so. That was pretty fun. And much better than the Gen 4 Indy car or Indy races. Rolling. The wind is blowing us forward. No, I don't think so. 73.67 that time, so we definitely used the right rear up a lot more. Let's go see. We got some people that did not finish the race, so I guess we'll watch their last laps. Let's see. We'll just hit F3 and see. 13's going to the wall. Pretty sure we saw that one ahead of us. 18's really headed up there. Weird angle. And there was actually contact. This is with the 15 and the 2. And 15 kind of just kept coming down. I guess the 2 loose, but really nothing. Eighteen in the wall. 10 in the wall. I'm just gonna see a lot of people hitting walls. But let's go to I thought Paul's name was familiar. He was gonna beat us there. Like, we didn't have anything for him, but then came this corner. And 23 goes up, hits the wall. So he's got to go high, and then when he does, he's not prepared for it. He's up high. Everyone's having issues in this corner, and then he gets loose off the corner there, and that gets us around him. But he was much quicker than us in the first run. But he did well. So let's take a look at the results. We're going to lose 22 I rating there. Definitely deserve to, because we were just really racing 2,000 IR guys. Gain 13 safety rating. Much easier to just go do a short track race now and gain safety rating, just because that took us an hour to get that 13. Very slow, but you know what? I'm happy with our finish. We moved up, we made passes. Didn't have any speed. We maybe could have got a couple more spots, but it would have been difficult. So, hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching.